and Young Promise Keepers, it's great to see you today, and I'm so glad that you tuned in. Our lesson today, we're talking about Lucky Charms. That's right, Lucky Charms. I know many of you are familiar with this cereal. This cereal says that a four-leaf clover, a horseshoe, a unicorn can bring you great luck. But today, Young Promise Keepers, we're going to learn that you don't need luck. Don't believe in superstition. You only need to rely on Jesus. Our memory verse today comes from Psalms 34:8. It says, "Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the person that goes to him for safety." Now our clip that you're about to watch is about a paralyzed man. That means a person that cannot walk. Jesus is going to do a miracle with this person. And is it luck? Or did the man rely on Jesus? Stay tuned and you will see.
God's story. Jesus heals a man. So part of God's story is when Jesus healed a guy on a mat. And it begins like this. Once, Jesus was in a town called Capernaum. People in other towns came to hear him teach and see him do miracles. Remember, a miracle is something that can only happen with God's power. And since Jesus is God's son, he has the power to do miracles. He brought a dead man back to life, changed water into wine, and fed thousands of people with one little boy's lunch. Kids, Jesus has all the power of God, but came to earth as a baby so he could experience life like we do. He understands how we feel when we lose a friend, get made fun of, or laugh so hard our stomachs hurt. So while Jesus was in Capernaum, crowds of people flocked to see him. But Jesus wasn't in a big stadium. He was in a regular house. So it was packed. In fact, it was so crowded that every door and window was blocked. Good thing Jesus didn't have claustrophobia. That's a fear of being in a cramped space. You know, like an elevator or maybe a doghouse. Anyway, there were people stuck outside who wanted to get in. One of them was the guy laying on a mat, carried by four of his friends. See, he was paralyzed, so he couldn't walk by himself. Let's call this guy Matt, even though the Bible doesn't tell us his real name. Matt's friends knew Jesus could do a miracle and make him walk. Problem is, there's no way five more people could fit into the house. So you'll never guess what Matt's friends did. They climbed up to the roof, dug a hole, and lowered Matt down, right next to Jesus. Yep, that's right. A hole right through the roof. Let's hope it didn't rain for a while. Some people probably thought Matt's friends were crazy, but they were willing to do anything to get close to Jesus. Are you willing to do whatever it takes to get close to Jesus? Well, Jesus was thrilled to see Matt. He loves it when we try to get close to him and ask for help. In fact, as soon as Matt was lowered down, Jesus said, "Friend, your sins are forgiven." Jesus had never met Matt before, but he calls everybody who believes in him his friend. And he will forgive us for the wrong things we do too, if we want to start following him. Now, lots of people were there to see Jesus, but a few of these people didn't believe Jesus was actually God's son. These people were the religious leaders, and they were thinking in their heads, "Who does Jesus think he is? Only God can forgive sins." Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he said, "I want you to know that God has given me the power to forgive sins." And just to make sure they knew he was God's son, he told Matt to pick up his mat and walk home. So Matt did. We don't know if Matt walked, skipped, or ran, but we do know that the people there said, "We have never seen anything like this." They were amazed.
Whoa.
And that, kids, is a miracle. And that's the story of Jesus healing a guy. So in case you missed it, here's a quick version. Matt needed a miracle. Crowds blocked him from Jesus. Matt's friends climbed on the roof. They dug a hole. They lowered Matt down, right next to Jesus. Jesus called Matt his friend. He forgave his sins. Then Jesus healed Matt. It was amazing. And that's a part of God's story.
Welcome back. Now, did the paralyzed man or his friends rely on luck, or did they rely on Jesus? You are right. They relied on Jesus. God does not allow bad things to happen, but oftentimes God uses those bad things to help grow our faith and let others come to Jesus. God didn't cause the man on the cot to be paralyzed, but he used that tragedy to change that man's life, his friend's life, and everyone in the house that was watching. God does not want us chasing rainbows and lucky charms. He wants us to chase after him. So don't put your hope in things today that's gone tomorrow. Put your hope in Jesus. Run to him, young promise keepers, and cling to him with all your might. God will be there for you in the good times and bad times. Now, with that said, we're going to have a little bit of fun. It's our activity time. And to do that, we'll be heading outside. So stay tuned. All right, promise keepers, we have made it outside. And guess who we have today? Dun, dun, dun. Wave, Chloe. Chloe's going to help us on our activity game today. To do that, you simply need a partner, which Chloe will be. You need, of course, your lucky charms, pool plates, and a blindfold that Chloe is already wearing. So, what we're about to do is start our game, and it's called Lucky Charm Game. The object of it is for each partner to guess three lucky charms in a row. Are you ready, Chloe? All right, she's already put her blindfold on, and we're going to see if Chloe gets three lucky charms in a row. All right, Chloe, go. Her first lucky charm is what, Chloe?
A hat.
She said a hat. Was she right, Promise Keepers? Wrong. She gets another try. Go, Chloe. What's that one?
A star.
Was it a star? She was wrong again, Promise Keepers. Chloe gets one more try. What is that one, Chloe?
A rainbow.
She said a rainbow. Yay! Chloe got that one right. Go again, Chloe. She gets another chance. All right, what was that one, Chloe?
A rainbow.
She said a rainbow. She didn't get that one right. So the next time, the second partner goes, and that means Chloe would give me my blindfold and I would get chances to go. So we want to say thank you, Chloe, for helping us with our activity today. As you see, this turned into a fun little game. You can enjoy Lucky Charms and eat much as you like. Just don't put your hope in a marshmallow, four-leaf clover, horseshoe, and a unicorn. Always put your hope in God's Son above, and he will never let you down. All right, with that being said, we're going to head back in to finish our lesson today. Say bye, Chloe.
Bye.
That was a fun activity. Now, I wonder, what type of prize is inside this box? When I was younger, one of my favorite things about cereal was finding the super cool prizes that was inside the box. However, if the box of cereal didn't come with the toy, I was a little bit disappointed. When you are a Christian, you're like a box of cereal. You have a prize inside. That's right, you have a prize inside, young promise keepers. Our guide work for the week. Parents, pray that God will help you model your reliance on him so that you will learn to trust in Jesus and not on superstition. At bedtime, quiz your kids on this week's memory verse from Psalms 34 and 8. As usual, young promise keepers, we always end in prayer. So let's bow our heads, put our hands together, and pray. Thank you, God, for your love and always being there. Teach us to run to you first when life gets hard. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you again, young promise keepers, for tuning in on this week. Don't forget, come back next Wednesday at 12 o'clock for our favorite fun Young Promise Keepers Bible lesson. See you soon. Thanks. And we will